Hey, what is this?
Cool.
It's Mike with the mic!
Warning, the following content may contain elements that are not suitable for some audiences. Your discretion is advised.
Hey, what up though, folks? We in here with author and producer, Tracey Arnold.
That's right.
How
that
are
sound
you?
Good.
Yeah.
It feel good when people say it.
Sound real good.
that's what matter, man. So we're going to be in here. We're going to talk a little about, she got a casting call she got going on. Let me put this up. Before we get going, let me make sure I hit my sponsors off. Refreshus15.com. DetroitCousins.com. Deuce5Clothing.com. And stuff, and definitely go download their music. We got AP to answer and everybody over there, and we just gonna keep pushing that along. So refreshus15.com, detroitcousin.com, and deuce5clothing.com. I'm gonna put their flyers up when we get done. So, but we gonna get off into this with Miss Tracey Arnold.
All right,
I got some stuff because I actually wrote a couple books, but I don't think I'm as far as along as you because you actually did a play, right?
Right.
Yeah, see, I ain't that deep down in there yet.
Yeah.
So how do you go about doing that? Like, you know, getting to that point to like.
Well, with me, I wrote the script and I just was blessed. Honestly, it was God. It was all God's doing. Mm-hmm. I just ran into the right people that you know, let me put the play on in different places. I got some good actors and. It's mostly a teenage play. This one is, or a movie rather. And, yeah. And then we got some really good actors and actresses that helped us out and we did a wonderful job.
So you wrote the book and then you did the play. Now you're doing the movie.
I just wrote it as a play actually.
Oh, okay. So actually, you never had
I
a
never
book.
Did oh, okay, it as okay. a book, right?
See, that's where I think I might be at. Like, even though I published it as a book,
mm-hmm.
it looked more like lines.
Mm.
You understand? So
yeah.
It looked more like a play, you know? So,
right.
But that's what I'm trying to. I'm gonna do mine to an audio book, but I'm gonna actually let people read the lines.
Right.
So, you know.
Well, I actually have a couple of people that I have. Written a few things and they want me to turn their writing into movies too. So this is just the first one
that we're working on. Oh, okay. But this is your first crack at producing a film?
Yes.
Oh, sweet.
It is.
So hey, we're gonna wish you luck on that, man.
Yeah.
I mean, gotta throw your rod in the water.
You got to. If you don't, you never will catch nothing.
That's how I be saying, because when I be thinking about it, I don't want to shoot nobody movies down, but some of these movies, they suck.
Right.
You know, so I that's what kind of make me be like, I got a chance.
Right, so, exactly.
Even the big production movies.
Right.
You know, a lot of movies come out, $30,
$40
million budget.
Talking about nothing.
But you shoot for 2 hours. And
right.
And they get up and leave.
Right, right.
So what's the last movie you seen? Or no. What's your favorite movie?
My favorite movie would be The Conjuring.
With the lady crawling upside down?
No, The Conjuring with the kids. They all moved into this
I ain't never
big,
seen
huge house, and it was a mother and father, and they had like five daughters.
What was the movie where they was crawling upside down?
I can't. What is the name of that? The Ring. The Ring.
I
yeah.
When you said The Conjuring, that's what I thought.
No.
Yeah.
The Conjuring.
You ever seen? I don't think I got no favorite, but you ever seen 25th Hour?
No, I haven't.
That's good. It got the Incredible Hulk dude in there.
Really?
Yeah, it's I'm like one of his older joints. What about American History X?
I don't think I've ever seen that
I'm about
one.
To leave you. You got to leave here with a list.
Okay, yeah.
I'm about to write you a list. Yeah. There's some good things, though. But so what got you into writing, like, plays and stuff?
This particular play, my brother passed away. Hmm. And then I've seen, I grew up near the Herman Gardens. And so, I know. And I've seen so many people that I knew are gone, you know. And my biggest question was, did they even know Christ, you know? Mm. And so with this movie, I would say it is a complete introduction to Christ at a child's level. Mm. But at the same time as this child is getting this understanding, an adult can too, at the same time, you know.
I mean, because the day you show up, that's your first day. It don't matter how old you is, you know.
Right, so, exactly. Yeah. And so I was inspired to write this from watching people die, and just wondering, did they even know Christ? Yeah. You know,
because I got into it pretty late in life. I mean, but I think it'd be due to how we be growing up.
Right. It was. It had a lot to do with my.
That. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, when you growing up in, like, we grew up in Herman Garden, like, literally one of our friends died every year of my life. You right. know what I'm saying? So when you right. get to 9, 10 friends, you be like,
wow.
God just sitting back watching this. But that's all faith and all that once you get in there.
Right, right.
Know? So I want to just make sure I get it. So what's the writing process, though? How do you go about it?
When I started writing, Receiving the Touch, I was just at work bored, and I was listening to some Take Six music. This was right after my brother had passed away, and their music really helped me out, you know, with the struggle of losing someone I was so close to. And anyway, I'm at work, I'm bored, I picked up a pencil and I started writing. When I got home, I had the first 5 scenes done.
Oh, sweet. See, mm-hmm. how I did, when I wrote mine, I wrote the character first, and then I wrote his attitude, then I put him in a job, and then I put different people around him and say, okay, well, this is the situation. How would they all react
to this right.
situation? That's how I basically kind of did that.
Right. I think I came up with the situation first of, you know, what they were going to be going through. Yeah. And then it took me a while to name characters. I have 4 children. Oh, and
I just got to pull the names people I knew.
Naming my kids was so hard for me. Yeah. So trying to name these characters, I use so many people I know. Yeah. I just use
not
their names.
I use first names.
First names. I didn't use anybody. I use one last name. Oh, you know.
Okay. But did you use first and last on one of them?
On my characters?
Yeah.
No.
I'm talking about the person you use the last name. Did you use their first name too?
I didn't.
Yeah. So
I kind of made up the last name, I think.
So
I don't know anyone.
So when you going into this whole film thing, right? So, like, who would be like a director you would say that you kind of model in your game after?
Oh, Tyler Perry, of course.
He's a genius, man.
I love him. He is a complete genius. I listen to and I read a lot of his work, and he really inspired me a lot.
He be going in on the preaching tip.
I've never heard him preach. I heard him
speak. I ain't gonna
speak,
say preach.
Right. I heard him speak. Yeah. And he is very, very deep, and I love him. Yeah.
I mean, I had went down to Georgia, man. That place is big. Land you got down there?
Yeah.
You can't go in there, though. Like, when I went up to the gate, like, I was, like, walking towards the gate. They came out like, hey, can I help you? I was like, I'm just trying to get a beat.
I just want
to
see.
Like, they like, no, nah, you better get a pass or something. So,
wow.
I don't know. Well, hey, what up, everybody? I got Michelle and Mike. We got Tracey Arnold here. Let me put your flyer up. Make sure people get it so we can She say, receiving the touch casting call every Saturday at 3 p.m., 13735 Puritan Avenue,
right?
And we got 586-557-9661. And that's the phone number, man. I think we getting a little shook up a little bit. There we go. But he has receiving the touch casting call every Saturday at 3 p.m., 13735 Puritan Avenue. And we just make sure we get that out there because... So who we looking for in the casting?
This movie takes place in a school. So we're looking for a high school. Mm-hmm. So we're looking for teenagers 14 and up. And we're also looking for adults. We have church scenes in there, so we got to fill the church up, you know? So, yeah.
We're looking for extras and stuff?
Right. We need lots of extras in this particular movie, this one.
Okay. So you got a place, the school to shoot at?
Yeah.
What school?
I'm trying to use, you remember where Barton Elementary used to be at on Joy Road in Ohio?
No.
Well, that's where it was, Joy Road in Ohio. And there is not a school anymore. Hmm. And a community center has bought the building. Oh, okay. So I've been talking to the people there trying to...
They still got classes? I mean, they still got desks?
Yeah, it's still set up like a school. Yeah, so it's actually perfect.
That'd be sweet right there. So so you got people already nailed down? Like you got...
Yeah, I have...
How many people you need?
32 altogether. I have
plus extras.
Right. I have a few of some really good singers. This is going to be a spectacular show. It's more like a musical type.
Oh, okay.
It's got like a complete of 14. Songs in it that either I or my sister wrote.
Oh, sweet.
So this is all original music, really good music.
Is the music like on YouTube and stuff?
Not yet.
Oh, okay.
We are in the middle of making a soundtrack right now. When I did the last play, it was a really good show. I mean, God was there. And I did a couple of radio, commercials or whatever. And so... we had an audience of maybe at least about 300 to 400 people.
That's a lot.
A lot. And I was it was so exciting. And
I remember I did that before when I did my book.
Mm-hmm.
I thought I sold a couple hundred.
Mm.
And I'm like, man, I only sold a couple hundred. I'm thinking in my head, I got all these friends, I only sold a couple hundred. Then I talked to another author, mm-hmm. and he's like, man, that's amazing. And I was let me quit kicking myself down. That's why I was like, man, 300 people, it's hard.
Right,
to get.
It was between 300 to 400 people. It was
hard to get
so nice.
People to get something.
Excuse me, but at the end of the show, people was asking me for the music, and I'm like, oh wow.
So,
And so, but it was a learning step for me, and
I you know what, I say that a lot on when I be doing my podcast. I tell people, we don't know, we don't be knowing what we be doing, but we gonna do it.
We gonna do it.
You know, it is nothing wrong with that, but you pass that information on to the next person, hey, next time before you do a play, make sure you put that music out first.
Right.
Because,
you
I'm
need
saying
that.
About I'm doing an audiobook, and when somebody shoot a film, it might not be about your story, it might not be about the soundtrack or nothing.
Mm-hmm.
It might be a producer somewhere, see that dude in the back that's doing his part real good, and he might get picked.
Right.
Sometimes that might be what all this is about.
Right.
And that's why we all gotta support. That's what I be saying. It'd be kinda hard to get people to come out, man, and support. You know what I'm saying?
It is.
I think we're getting better though.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm talking about black people. We getting better. I mean, it's just what it is, I think we gotta more just do this kind of stuff and the people will come to you.
Right.
Instead of going around looking for everybody, just stand still sometimes and just wave your flag,
Right, exactly. Because my biggest issue was finding, when I write a song, I can hear the music, I can hear everything when God is pouring it into me at that moment, right? But I can't play a flute. So,
need people to make music?
I need, right.
It's a guy right here, Montez.
Mm-hmm.
He make music. He do music.
Oh, okay.
So she said she, oh, so you open to taking people on?
Yeah, before I'm open.
Before I say it. So she's yes. open to people that's making beats. What they call that, like the score or something like that?
Yeah, I'm really looking for someone that can play by ear, play music by ear. Because like I said, when I get a song, I can hear it already. I just want to show you.
That's
know what I'm saying?
I used to rap with Tez. He's a pretty good dude, man.
Oh, okay.
He's a real good dude.
Well, I would love to meet you, Tez.
she just added me so you can look on my friends list, and she on there. But let me put this back up one more time, make sure people don't miss it. But
right.
She said every Saturday, so get out there. It don't cost anything?
No, it don't cost anything.
Just come on up there with your skills.
Right.
See what you do. 13735 Puritan Avenue. I should come up there and give it a shot.
You should. You should, seriously.
You don't do no acting?
Me?
Yeah, you ain't gonna get in
it? I was in it when it was a play. Yeah. I don't plan to be in it a movie, though. All right. Yeah.
So, wait, so you need teachers, right? So you do need some adults?
Well, yeah, I need plenty of adults. There's only 2 school teachers in here, okay. And they're both females, but they sing. Oh, so
that kicks me out right
no
there.
But there is a pastor that I'm looking for. He also sings, but he plays a big role. He's a pastor of a church, but he also is a counselor at a school.
Okay.
You know, and at the school, and so he helped the kids out any way he can, giving them encouragement, you know.
I can't see me acting. I mean, like,
I can see you acting. I can see it.
I'm one of those people that believe everybody could do everything.
I
really believe that. Like, when people be like, how you write a book? Or like, what make you think you can write a book? I be like, what make you think you can't?
Exactly.
Instead of wasting that time coming to me. That's why I say, like, something like this, I'm like, yeah, I had you on here because I'm not that far yet. Like I said, I'm going that way, but I want to get it done. I really want to do a movie. My thing is, like, I'm not trying to kick nobody thing down, but I'm just saying, like, I don't want to do, like, a $5,000 movie. I'd rather wait and try to get me a couple $100,000, and if I can't, that option is always there. You understand what I'm saying? But
well, there are ways to get funding for movies, and it's just opened back up in Michigan, a movie grant that you can get.
Yeah, they get that tax break and stuff, right?
Yeah, you could.
I'm saying that's probably why they trying to come here and get that money and stuff. Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
Take it right back.
So get it while it's hot.
Yeah, that's what I be saying. But you got to do the work. Like, most people don't want to do the work.
You got to do the work.
They'll see you doing your movie or your play, and they want you to school them. Like, nah, man, I sit up on the computer all night. I can give you as much info as I can, but...
You got to really do your own work.
It ain't no cakewalk.
Everybody do things differently. Yeah. So I can't, you know, you can't expect that the way I'm going to do what I'm doing, you're going to be able to do it the same way and it's going to work out for you. You got to get your own feel in it, you know?
Because this like gospel mind, like horror mystery. Like, I got a dude cheating on his wife and
I do have I said, this is one.
Okay.
So I got some other ones.
That's
too.
Why I got like, I probably got like 5. I got like 7, I think, that I actually completed. But I got like 5 published, like 2 children's books.
Mm.
And I don't know how I ended up all the way around there. Like, my grandbabies came around, my son, I got 3 children's books.
Mm-hmm.
And I just kind of wrote it for my kids and did the graphics and all of that. But
that's really good. Yeah, I think so.
That's why I say that. They hear me out here knocking. You know what I'm saying? Like, that'd be as soon as they open the door, like stuff like this. When they open the door, we'll be all right.
Mm-hmm.
So, who would you like to work with? Like, okay, if I gave you $30 million for a budget, who you going to get to fill that?
Tyler Perry first. And he'll fill the rest in.
He's
bad.
He got his click that he worked with.
And that's what my pastor keep telling me. You need to get you a click like Tyler Perry got. I'm trying to get my click, y'all. Join my click now. Meet me every Saturday. Yes, it is.
Because when Tyler Perry first started, when we used to go, we saw a couple plays. We ain't know none of them. They was in the plays, not in the movies.
And now they're like, doing good. Every one of them, you know?
Well, he definitely doing good.
Exactly.
I'll be tweeting him and Instagramming him like, man, we got to talk. We got to talk about
right, exactly. But I would love to sit down and have a 20-minute conversation with him.
I'll be thinking that. Like, I know he probably, because he got to be too busy.
Right. You know he is.
He probably don't get much sleep, right? Don't eat right. So who would you say, I would say, like, your favorite actor or actress?
My favorite actor would be Shamar Moore. Is that his name? Yeah. He is my favorite actor. I love him and everything he's done so far.
Favorite, or you think he the best, or just your favorite?
He's just my favorite, okay, my personal favorite. The best, I would say, is... No. What's his name? Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. What's his name? Will Smith. He's a very good actor.
He is. I got him top five. I got Denzel in there. Denzel, Will Smith. Jamie Foxx. So I think the best acting, like, gotta be Ray, man. Like, when you watch the movie Ray, I don't see Jamie Foxx. I see Ray Charles. Like, when I saw Ali, you don't see Will Smith.
Right.
That's what make you a good actor.
Exactly. Me too.
Go, what's his name? Forest Whitaker? What you think Zach said, Forest Whitaker? I ain't never liked Forest Whitaker because, I don't know. It seemed like It seemed like he being himself.
But do you know he has a twin? Well, they're not twins, but he has a brother that they look so much alike that, and he's an actor too. Mm. When you see him in movies, you don't know which one is which unless you look at the name.
Last King of Scotland. You ever seen that where he was the Idi Amin, I guess?
Yeah. That was good. That was good.
Yep, that was what she said.
But was that him or his brother?
Yeah, see.
Because there's a new show that's out right now that people were swearing that it was Forrest Whitaker, but it's his brother.
What, the one on Netflix? It was on Netflix?
It was on, I don't know, my
I
brother.
I scrolled past this movie.
We just had a big conversation about it to where my brother had to Google it. You know, he Googles everything. So he had to Google it to show us. I was like, wow, I did not know that.
I was telling this guy that's at work, like a younger guy, like when we was younger, like, wasn't no Google. Like, we had to, like, go to the library and see whatever. You have to put the rolls of film in there and roll it to go back to the day.
Yeah.
I ain't doing that. She said Don Cheadle. I ain't never been no Don Cheadle type dude neither.
I like Don Cheadle. I like him.
I like him, but I really
liked him when he played Blue. You know, Denzel Washington. He was second to Denzel Washington in the movie.
I don't know what that is. Nope.
And he played Blue. You don't remember that? Oh, I love
what
that movie.
What was the name of the movie?
I can't think of it.
Let me put this out here about you, because I just met her. And we sat here for like 30 minutes. She don't know no actors.
I'm not good with names.
You admitted you said I ain't good with names.
I'm not good with names.
You don't know the movie?
I know the movie. I be knowing the movies.
It's a guy. Like that. We gotta come with some, we gotta get a little more
info. Said Don Cheadle played Cheetah. What I have you pronounce
it? 100 movies.
Okay, listen. Denzel Washington was a part of the movie. Don Cheadle was his name was Blue in the movie, and he was a gangster. Denzel Washington was a laid back man, just bought his first house, and in Florida.
She's at Moe Better Blues.
No, it's not Moe Better Blues. What is the name of that? I can't think of it, but it's a really good one. If y'all can come up with the name of, I mean.
I think I'm going to go out on the limb and say you just make it.
No, I'm not. If I can think of the name of that, it's a really good movie.
We're going to make sure somebody going to come through with it.
Hopefully. Y'all, come on. Y'all know that movie I'm talking about.
So how long have you been actually like writing, or did it kind of hit you out the blue?
It pretty much hit me out the blue, like I said, after my brother passed, which was...
What year was that? I'm sorry to hear that, though.
It was 1997.
Okay.
And he just so happened to pass away on my birthday.
Oh.
And it was just tragic, you know. I just never expected it, you know. And
I'm finna find this. Go ahead.
And when he...
I don't believe you. She said double in a blue dress.
That's it. Devil in the Blue Dress. That's it right there. That is the best movie, I'm telling you.
You say that's the best movie?
It's the best. That's the best movie ever.
Devil in the Blue Dress.
That's it.
Devil in the Blue Dress. They must have been younger or something.
No, they wasn't that much younger.
It's 95.
Was it 95?
Yeah.
Yeah. Time is just ticking by me. But yeah, when my brother passed away, It took me on the loop, you know, and I just wasn't expecting it. And I just started thinking about salvation a lot, you know.
It do be a wake-up call and stuff. Yeah. But sometimes it's sad to say that somebody have to pass away, but sometimes that's what it take for somebody else to open
their
eyes.
It do. And, yeah, okay. So.
Yeah, they got an old girl in here. What's her name? Lisa Nicole Carson. She be in some stuff, too.
Oh, yeah.
She's, she's pretty cool, too. So he wasn't making it up. It's Devil in a Blue Dress. Where
Devil
God,
in
a, I don't remember them being in that, but it's from 95.
You have to watch it. Watch
95,
it.
I was 14, 15. I
see, that's why you ain't getting to it yet.
I wasn't watching no movies like this yet.
Yeah.
But, yeah,
but watch it now.
I'm going to check it out. I'm definitely going to check it out.
It's good.
So, I just, like, when it comes to, like, getting set up, because I want people, because there's people, I'm sure there's people out there that want to get to where you at.
Mm-hmm.
So, is it some kind of budget that go with that, or is we kind of piecing it together, or?
When I first started it off, I was pretty much piecing it together.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I'm working on a budget. You know, that's what I'm working on, getting my budget together.
Mm-hmm.
Getting a trailer, that's what I'm really trying to do, is get... really working on, rather, is getting the trailer made.
Mm-hmm.
With the trailer, that is how you can get into the getting the movie grants.
Yeah.
You got to have a trailer.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, yeah. But that's what I say. Like, that's the route you take it. Like,
mm-hmm.
I don't know, man. I just be feeling like when it comes to stuff like that, I really don't want to kind of put my stuff in other people's hands. I would rather, you don't want to do like a GoFundMe? We can start a GoFundMe. let's get that
going. Yeah, let's do a GoFundMe.
See, the stripper got like $100,000. Oh, she got like she was getting paid. The girl fell off the pole. She was up stripping and climbed up the pole all the way up to the top and fell
and got paid.
And everybody started sending her money, and we can't get a dime.
Dang,
to do something good. You know, right. I mean, I'm not saying that she don't deserve it, but I'm just saying if y'all got it for that, have it for something else too.
Right, exactly.
But yeah, I think she had raised like $100,000 or so or something like
that.
That's a lot of money for a film.
It is. Yeah. For a fall.
You ever look up prices in a film? I saw this one price. They shot a movie for $7,000 and they made like $500,000.
Right. No, well, like, I was still going with it with being a play. But mm-hmm. my son, one of his good friends, took one of his writings and made it into one of these Detroit movies.
Yeah.
And he did it so low budget. And he was like, you can do this, do that, and yeah. But exactly. I don't want to do that low budget. I don't want to slight myself, you
That's
know?
That's how I feel, though. That's
and I
feel.
Have a really, really good story. Mm-hmm. I have to say that, even though, you know, I wrote it or whatever. It's a really good story. Mm-hmm. And it's so touching. And it actually moves you. And I pray over it every day.
Mm-hmm.
And I just ask God that one person out of the world, one person can find salvation through it, I'm good.
That'd be the payment right there.
That's good. Yeah, I'm good. But it's not just about going to church or nothing like that. It's not about that. It's about really, truly finding salvation.
Right.
You know, because, you know, a lot of people think, well, if you don't go to church, you ain't saved for real. That's not true. Mm-hmm. You know, salvation is accepting Christ into your heart. That's salvation.
First.
Right there.
You can go to church, and if he ain't in there,
you still in a bad place.
A worse place.
Right, exactly.
Now you faking it in church.
Yeah. So think about it is we can fake with other people, but we can never fake with God.
Yeah,
he know who his children are, you know, and so we just have to spread his word as best way as we can, you know, the truth.
I think that when it come to like, I'm going to say like church movies,
mm-hmm.
you got to kind of edge it up a little bit.
Right.
To get people to lean in on it. Because
right.
if it's too churchy.
Right.
It kind of, and I think Tyler Perry do a good job.
He do.
That.
He do a really good job.
He do a really good job with that.
Yeah. But, and this is like, this is not a church movie, I wouldn't say. I'd say, it, you know, it's got to deal with a lot of real issues that people of today are facing, especially teenagers. That's what it really, you know, focus on teenagers, you know.
Because we got to get a hold
teen
of
pregnancy, babies. Selling drugs, gangs, all that. It focuses on all that. But it's a way out. You know what I'm saying? Everything we can get ourselves into, there is a way out. It's called Jesus. But
people just don't believe that.
That's right. It's a way out of whatever we can work ourselves into. And this movie reflects that.
And let me put the flyer up again because we're going to make sure y'all get out. Because here's y'all chance right here.
Right. Come and join us.
I might throw my name in the hat. I'm on the fence. We're receiving the touch casting call. It's every Saturday, 13735 Puritan Avenue. It's Miss Arnold. The number is 586-557-9661. Mm-hmm. And she say, come on, you said, but teenagers to early adults?
Yeah. Well, no, not I'm not going to say early adults, teenagers and up.
And up, okay. But right. Like 13. What is it, high school?
14. Yes, yeah, okay, high school. So 14 and up is what I'm really trying to work with.
12, big as these kids.
Boy, tell me about it. I was looking at my grandkids like, woo, y'all can be in this movie, but they're young, you know, but yeah, they're just so grown.
I think that'd be the hardest part, though, getting people to, you know, just be available.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying, and staying on point. Like, if you do, I mean, I know you probably asking for people to play parts for free. I still need you to cut your hair, man. I still need you to bring that same outfit you had on, because I don't want you going to the bathroom with a white shirt on and then come back out. You got on a blue shirt, like,
right?
Come on, man, let's.
You can't do it like that. And that was something that was kind of difficult for me because especially with one girl that played the person, her name was Trina, and she's the girl that everybody picks on. Hmm. And so I wrote in here that she has on a purple jogging suit, and it's got to be an ugly one. So I went through kind of stuff trying to find this ugly purple jogging suit. So it was crazy, but it worked out good, you know. And it was real exciting, though. Everything about it, I was so nervous and scared part.
You got like a production team, or you? Gonna
yeah,
be
I got a production team.
But you still just kind of gotten it.
Yeah, I have a director. Mm. It's my sister.
What's her name?
Her name is Andrea Tiggs.
Andrea Tiggs. Yeah. Let's give her credit. Don't
yeah,
give her.
That's my
I can't
director.
Just
say she's my sister. Right, okay.
But she say continuity is necessary. I think that's the most important, like just keeping the flow of the story. You know
right.
what I'm saying?
Right.
Like, we were just talking, y'all was talking about the movie Us. It's a real good movie if you can get it over them first 30 minutes.
Oh.
You know what I'm saying? That's how I think. But then it kind of, I don't know.
That's what happened with me. I didn't get past them first 30 minutes.
Yeah, because it was kind of taking a little long, and then
yeah,
I don't know. Like, I don't know, it'd be like some movies like that. Like, if I go outside and I see me at the end of my driveway, I'm not finna. Hey,
right?
No, you.
It's gonna
get
be a
shot.
Whole nother.
You finna be done this movie
a
over
whole
10
nother
minutes.
Program.
Man, I'm saying, you come outside and you at this, man.
Right.
I get it though, but you know, I mean, it's a good deal. Jordan Peele, a good dude. He's a good one. I like him. So.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I'm trying to think of some good like actual writers, man. But I don't really pay attention to like who write the movies. I just be like, if the movie.
A lot of people don't. I've noticed that. You know, a lot of people
but
don't.
It's a lot of places to make money. I'll be telling people, like, you can write music for the movie. You can actually write characters. Like, I didn't know that. Like, when I was reading some books, like, you can take Us and write a part two and send it to him. He might take it.
He might. He just might.
And it's just be like, man, we got to get out there first. But I like what you're doing here, because, I don't know, man, if anything else, it inspired people.
Yeah,
because sometimes it takes somebody else jumping out there first, and like I said,
to get you to jump out there, exactly.
And we can do it, exactly. And we'll definitely get over here and what is a casting call? What do they call that? Audition.
Yeah. Well, I'm calling this a casting call. Mm-hmm. I'm not actually at the audition part yet. Okay. I'm just trying to see how many people I can get to say, okay, yeah, I'm on board. Mm-hmm. Then we can go through the. Who can I put you? Yeah.
But we gotta come on out though. This the thing, it's free and it's your chance. You come in here and they can shine in this.
Shine.
And then you can go off and get you you end up being in Marvel movies and you can say I started with the little casting call over there on Puritan Avenue.
That's right.
That'll be everybody, you know. That's why I say when we come together, we can do a lot of stuff.
We can. And there are so many talented people right here in the city of Detroit. Mm. I, when I was putting on the plays and everything, and I was doing the same thing, a casting call. I was getting so many people that were just so talented. And I wish I could have kept them on, you know, but they grew up, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, yeah. And so they're, you know, so
that's what happened with Harry Potter.
Yeah,
remember, he grew was a up. Baby, and then he grew up, and he had to yeah. beard and all that. And I was like, all right, now.
Until like, people, my nieces say, okay, now, yeah, no more Harry.
No more Harry Potter. But we're going to take a break, man. We got Moe Corleone coming up, man. We got reminiscing, man. We're going to take us a break. We come back and got some more questions, and we can get to this. But let me put the flyer up again first before we go to this, because we don't want nobody to miss this, because she say she need 32 people?
32.
30, wait, how many men and women?
It's like 15 women and 17 men.
Okay, but boys and men, every Saturday, 3 p.m., 13735 Puritan Avenue. Call Miss Arnold at 586-557-9661. Yep, that's right. I'm gonna get, we gonna get into this Moe Corleone, man. Y'all have at it.
Reminiscing on those times, man. Know how that shit go, man. Go to school all week. Can't wait till the weekend, man, to get it in. You know what I mean? Take y'all niggas down memory lane, man. Rogers versus Rennie had 20 and 8. Before baby party that started at 8. Adidas track suit and some crazy eights. Curfew at midnight and I can't be late. Niggas doing routines when you get them hype. I'm in the corner with a cutie, I think I'm Kurt Sykes. Bass hair rental or the Hmong bikes. Ham sandwich, sugar cookie from that lunch, psych. Kept a nigga right. Goofy with the wallabies, mean you getting money. Gore-Tex boots, man, this shit funny. Byzantine chain, same color honey. 36 degrees and it's probably sunny. Burger King hired with a work permit. Ride the Bertrand for a guest fit. Three girls want me and I can't commit. Reminiscing on the times that I can't forget. That's just a Friday night right there, baby. I ain't even got in the Saturday, you know what? You know what I mean? Show you how these Saturdays go, nigga. First down, coat color, honeycomb. Walking down the road, I'm headed to Tones. Penny jersey on with a pair of phones. Silver sidekick, what's my second phone? Greenfield bus headed to the mall. Need a Cinnabon walking through the mall. Eddie Bauer with some yays, I think I missed them all. Cutie say she got a man, that's a curveball.
Lord help us all.
Nokia minutes running low, need a refill. Two-way message saying what the deal. 10 deep on her way, Detroit wheels. Jordan tied around my neck cause these niggas steal. Two-step to Coffee Brown on the roller skates. See you skating with that nigga make my stomach ache. Black and purple polo sweater make the double take. Triple black Jabot jeans with the Jordan 8s.
Check it out, man. All streaming platforms and stuff like that. iTunes, Spotify, and all that. Y'all know all the music I play on here. I link it at the end of the video so y'all can check it out and download their stuff. But we here with Tracey Arnold, and she got with Receiving the Touch.
Mm-hmm.
Cast a call. Let me put this up, make sure, because this is y'all time to shine right here.
Right,
I say
now.
That. I think people need to take advantage of these kind of opportunities while we got the chance, because at the end of the day, we don't get that many.
Right. And if nothing more, you could put it on your resume that you actually worked in a fit in a movie. So
yeah, you can put that out on anybody.
Mm-hmm. My
what I want to get into a couple of more things about the whole shooting and like directing, because I just want to make sure people can walk away with something from this. Mm-hmm. How many people do you think it? How many people do you have, like, as far as your production team go?
Ooh,
because people,
I'm still looking for people. Mm-hmm. I have about 15 now.
Okay,
but I need more people. That's a lot, I need. Well, you know, I gotta have stage help.
I mean, I'm saying it's a lot, but it's not enough. But it's still a lot.
Right, it's a lot, but I have, you know, it's stage help. You know, you gotta have somebody putting the stage together. You gotta have makeup artists. You gotta have. So clothing. I'm doing it all. Oh, and and so I'm looking for a lot of people.
Volunteers?
Come on out. Volunteers would be lovely.
It's a girl on my friend list. I forgot her name, like Chantel. I look her up for you. She be doing makeup and stuff.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I could really use her.
Yeah, yeah.
I could really use her hair, makeup, someone work the clothing line, you know.
So what about that? I got friends, the sponsors with clothing line.
Really?
Yeah, maybe you can.
That would be good because
that's advertising for them too.
I actually name a clothing line in the movie.
Mm-hmm.
And so a friend of mine out of Chicago has a clothing line. I was going to use him, mm-hmm. but I haven't been able to get back in touch with him as far as, you know, mm-hmm. him getting this gear together. Is one of the females in there, and she got to be from
Done
head
up.
To. Yeah. Okay. Pretty much.
But that's what I be saying about like Detroit films. I don't know why that could be something we could do. If somebody got a clothing line, hey,
exactly,
send me a box over. Everybody wear your stuff in there, and what you know,
right?
We got to do that. But like music too. But you got music though,
yeah. Right? But my thing is, I don't have the music. I have the songs. Look, I got the words,
okay,
and I got the rhythm of how I want it to be. But like I said, I can't play a flute, so. If
you
I can get
play
some,
nothing.
I
used to know how to play the guitar back in the day when I was little.
When I was young, my parents bought a piano.
I
never did learn how to play.
I like to learn how to play the piano.
I would now.
Like the piano and probably the saxophone might be the smoothest.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That'll definitely get you some credit. Somebody come walking in and you in there playing the piano. That'd be sweet though.
Yeah.
But I think that's something. But you open to people with songs though? Are you open to that? Like if somebody call you and be like, hey,
I'll get this song. Not for this particular film, but for the other ones.
Music. How I be thinking about it is like, if you use my song, I'm just saying like if I had a song, I'm going to tell everybody, like, hey, my song is in this movie. That's
exactly.
why I be thinking about, like, cross-advertising.
Exactly.
Where, you know, nobody is really spending money. You know,
right.
It don't cost nothing for you to give me the song. It don't cost me nothing to put it in the movie. So, but we can attract people in if we want to.
Right. And that's what happened with my son. He produces music. Mm-hmm. And his friend that I was telling you about that did this Detroit movie, mm-hmm. and he used my son's songs in there.
Yeah.
So I was like, oh, okay, that's neat. Yeah. So
that's what I'm doing with my audiobook. I'm doing it like an actual movie.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to use like people's stuff that I play on the show and stuff, use they music and stuff. Because like I say, it don't matter who get up there. Somebody got to get up there.
Right.
Because I mean, that's how it go. Because like I feel like it always bounce around music, movies. It just seemed like one city be going at it, and then once somebody else crack out of one city, then everybody want to run back to Detroit.
Mm-hmm.
This could be it right here. You know
right.
what I'm saying? So we
right.
got to make sure we get behind it because, I mean, it's different for one thing. We got all the hood movies. We done seen every dope deal.
Right.
We done seen somebody get killed every kind of way. We done seen
right.
all that already. So, and plus, I think that's what it is. We got to show them that we do stuff different.
Exactly.
You know what I'm because a lot of people look at Detroit like, I don't know, Detroit.
We just on a one-track mind or something.
Detroit been following the trends lately, like these last 20 years. It seems like, I don't know. Mm-hmm. I be wanting to blame the internet, but I can't. You still got to make the choice, though. But somebody on here said, did we vote? Yes, I did vote. I got my sticker somewhere.
Yeah, I voted, too.
And I ain't going to say who I voted for, but we know who
right.
I didn't vote for. we do know that, though.
Right.
I mean, I just think that, like, right, first things first, we got to get my man out of there.
Right, exactly.
And you know what? Here's the thing about Donald Trump. And I'll be telling, and this is, I like him as a person,
mm-hmm.
just not my president. Like, he's, I think he's a good businessman. I mean, you know, he didn't get that rich not being, you know, you got to know something to make that much money. I just don't want you to be my president. Mm-hmm. But I feel that way about Jesse Jackson. Like, I like Jesse, but I don't think I want you my president. You know what I'm saying? So that's why I say we got to get back to getting people in there. First things first, we got to get him out of there. And then we can worry about the right person, because he's right. definitely, he out there shooting the tissue. Come on, man. You can't.
Right.
He got sexual charges. He on the chopping block to get impeached. Come on, man. Like, if he Barack would have did, if Barack would have shot some tissue to something, oh my man, they'd be ready to stone that man.
They would have stoned
man.
Him,
and they already would. They were so disrespectful to Barack, he called his wife a man.
Right.
Like, y'all can't.
And she's a beautiful black woman. Beautiful.
I mean,
you know how dare they?
That's because none of us is beautiful to a racist person. You know, so that's the person who be saying that. I don't know, man. We just, what you think? What you think we need? What you think if you was running? What would you offer us?
If I was running for president,
what would be your first thing? First things first.
First thing would be to let's get these people in homes. It's the homeless issue is too bad out here, and it's crazy that we should even be going through this. This is supposed to be America, the richest country ever. How do we have people that don't have a place to live, place to sleep?
They're up there playing the $1 billion game. I was talking to somebody about this a few weeks ago. You remember, like, when we was younger, like, you would hear a rap song and somebody be like, I spent $1,000 in the club. That was a lot. $1,000 ain't a lot of money no more. Now they talking millions and billions. Now we like, I don't need $1 billion.
No, you know, I don't need it.
Like, I don't know, man. But they say the richer you get, you got to become a Republican. To protect your money, because they make sure the rich stay rich.
Yeah.
I guess once you jump that gate, if you care about that, but I just don't see, like, why a person need $2 billion.
I can't either.
And then we just...
Unless they're going to do something with it to help out other people. You know what I'm saying? People don't understand, or they don't really care about the concept of we get blessed to be a blessing. We don't get blessed so we can harbor it all and keep it to ourselves. We're supposed to, when God bless you with something, you're supposed to share that. You're supposed to be a blessing.
If it's information or anything.
Whatever it be. It's not always money. It's all kind of things.
I think that's where we at now. We pretty much kind of lost in the sauce, because I don't know who turned it into that $1 billion competition. But like this whole American dream,
mm-hmm.
We falling victim to that anyway. Like,
yeah.
I don't know, because my personal thing is, if I can make $100,000 off 40 hours a week, I'm good. You can get a new car, you have a nice house, you can eat.
Right.
Now, anything over that, we finna party, like all of us though. But that's how I feel about it. Like, that's why I like advertise people's stuff on here. I have, like,
right.
come on here, because I'm in a position to buy this stuff, and it helped me out though. You coming on here, your people might see this and be like, oh man, let me order one of his shirts or something.
Somebody exactly. see
that. And that's how it kind of go. But we down here though. That's why I say once, I don't even want to go up there. Not that
we just got to remember and just be humble. That's so, the main
but it's
thing.
It's so hard with the, I think it's hard humble. With the competition.
I mean, it depends on the person. I mean, I personally, I don't really care about what somebody else think about me or how they feel about me. I'm me. I can't be nobody else but me. You know what I'm saying? And so I use my time to be me. I don't try to be nobody else or none of that.
That'd be the main thing. Well, that's what I say about Detroit. Like, and I ain't knocking nobody. Let me put this out here, because I don't argue with nobody in the streets.
Right.
But like, that's how I be saying, like, about this whole, like, dreadlock thing.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it kind of like Atlanta did it, now everybody running around Detroit. Like, come on, man. Like, I'm not saying that's not you,
mm-hmm.
but it just seemed like it's not you. Because we wasn't doing that. And it's just like all this kind
of... It just popped up all of a sudden.
And that's why I be saying, like, I'm glad you stepping out and doing something different, because we done, like I say, we done saw all the hood movies and all of that already.
Mm-hmm.
And we done saw everything else. So why not give it a shot from a different side?
Exactly.
That's what I was trying to do with mine, because in my book, like, the guy sleep with a transsexual.
Mm.
So I actually want a woman to play that part. I don't want to get like no
real guy,
because that'll probably make him feel weird.
Right, and then exactly.
I gotta find somebody else for that, and it's already hard enough because I don't know how you do it. Like, I mean, me, I'm doing an audiobook, and it's like people done came over and read their parts, but it's like then when you know when somebody don't show up, I'll be mad. Like.
You talking about being mad. Yeah. Oh, man, like, oh, I have my day.
It's in my head. I got to get it out.
Right.
And it's like, you know, I know people got lives and they got work, got whatever. Plus, I'm not paying you, so I can't really be like, hey, today, you know. But
right.
I can.
But the thing is, I'm working towards that. I'm working towards getting everybody paid, you know. That's why I really want to do this trailer so that I can get this movie grant, because I'm just trusting
in
God.
That's another guy on here, Zach Daniels. I'll make sure. That's why I said I'm about to write you a list for you, Lee. Zach Daniels is real good with the camera work. He's been doing some stuff. Yeah, he's real.
Now, I just purchased my own cameras. Mm-hmm. So, yeah.
You know, talking about as far as, like, filming, like, ads and stuff. He did something for a car place. So I'll show it to you.
Oh, okay.
But he's real good.
Like, but I'm saying I purchased my own cameras, but I need somebody to do them. You know what I'm saying? I need somebody to hold them.
What kind of camera you get?
I don't know the names of them. Please don't make me go there. But my brother, he is really good with the audio and all that type of stuff. And so he has his own studio. And so he's like, okay.
Wait, what's his name? You can't be just walking past. You get him. You got to let him.
His name is, we call him Bruiser. Everybody should know him as Bruiser. But his name is Daryl Tiggs. And no, I don't even know if he on Facebook, but he made some of that Cosmic Cars. You remember that Cosmic Cars?
No.
That house music? You probably don't. You're probably too young for that.
No,
but yeah, he was into making that house music and stuff.
Wait, like the mix, like little mixed dance mixes and stuff?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, man. Mm-hmm. I ain't never been no dancer or nothing like that, so I ain't been no party or nothing.
Right.
Yeah. But yeah, Daryl, come on, Daryl, you gotta get your social media. Okay? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Come on, I had a friend like that. He just got a Facebook this year, and I'm like, where you been at? Like, everybody got something, but I don't think he had nothing.
Right.
And I don't know, but that's the best way to do is free advertising.
Right. Like, it really is.
Man, you could click share and share, and once people share, because that's what happened with the Popeyes thing. Remember?
Mm-hmm.
They was like, yeah, y'all saved us $25 million advertising. Yeah, we did. But we could do the same thing for this. If everybody get out and share it and come to it, let me put it up again, folks.
Mm-hmm.
I want to make sure don't nobody miss it, man. It's Receiving the Touch cast call. Receiving the Touch is the name of the movie, right?
The movie, yes.
Okay, you would say F.O.C. Productions.
Right.
That's your production company?
Yes. Okay. F.O.C. Productions.
What
that means Followers of Christ.
Followers of Christ.
Mm-hmm.
It don't get no right than that. Right? But it's every Saturday at 3 p.m., 13735 Puritan Avenue. Y'all can give her a call at 586-557-9661. Her name is Miss Arnold. Yeah. I don't know, man. I mean, that's pretty much it for me. You done broke it down for me. I just want to see it get done. So, like I say, I could point you to some people that I know that could probably help you along the way.
That would be great.
That'd be sweet,
that
man.
That would be great.
What's his name? Brian. I went to school with him. He looked like Vin Diesel.
Mm-hmm.
And like I just been watching like him, and he just moving up. Now he played. Did you see Aaron Hernandez's story on A&E?
I heard about it, but
I didn't watch it.
A&E
or the ID channel.
Yeah,
that's him.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, if you ever see that was him. He had played that, and he started off at like a Northwestern Tech commercial.
Mm.
And it was just kind of like, but. That's what we got to do with stuff like this. So make
right.
sure y'all do that. Just if you don't come out, you can tell somebody else. Everybody knows somebody that, and this is the crazy part. Most of y'all ain't doing nothing else. I mean, I don't even want to sound like that bad, but like you ain't got no job or nothing. Come on out, put your name in a hat. Like I said, they might see this movie and be like, man, I don't care about that story. Who was that guy?
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
That's how it usually go.
Right.
Yeah, but. We
right, come on, join my clique, because this is the first movie.
How many you got lined up?
Right now, I got four. That's
okay,
ready.
Okay. That's ready,
ready
to go.
Yeah.
Yeah. See, there we go. Because once you get the rolling, if this do good, she gonna be calling you back.
You know it.
Be in the clique by the end.
Yeah.
That's why I
get
say,
my
I mean,
clique.
Watch some Tyler Perry movies and them shows. He used the same 10 people.
Yeah.
This is like, you know, he'll bring in a star and stuff now, cause he getting too big. Mm-hmm. He can't be really messing with us no more. so what advice, before we get out of here, what advice would you give to somebody that's on the fence about, you know?
First thing is, whatever it is that you want to do, just do it. Don't think about it. Just do it. The first thing you have to do is start writing down exactly what it is that you want to do, exactly what you want to see, your dream. Write that down and then pray over it. You know, God is really a miracle worker. And once you do that, just look forward to move, because, you know, that's exactly what I did.
My dad say, you want to cross the bridge, you got to pay the toll.
That's right.
And that's it. You got to put your dog in the fight. I be listening to the motivational videos on YouTube all the time, and they be just talking all that. And I be like, yeah, you know, they get you hyped up. Right. So that's why I say, so we'll just make sure we keep an eye on this. So, and you have to definitely have to come back when it get done, so we can see how it go, because I don't know nobody never did a movie.
Okay.
I be saying that to people too. Like, I wrote a book, man. Because of me, you know, a published author.
Well, I'm going to have to give you my introduction, okay? You've heard of Tyler Perry? Now, have you met Tracey Arnold?
Now we in here. See what I'm saying? I can go back to this when you up there. You're like, man, she's on my crib. But you know what? That's how it can trickle down. I be telling people that all the time. If you go off and be famous, I put this video on YouTube, a lot of people watch it, I can make some money off of that.
Exactly.
So, it's like, so we can all kind of pedal along.
Exactly. And that's how we got to do. We got to touch each other, give each other a nudge on the back sometime, you know. And I'm going to tell you this. I got to say this. A lot of my good friends, people I consider my good friends, told me, you should just give up. Don't worry about it no more.
Oh, man, I done heard that too.
So you gon' hear that. You gon' hear that from people that you consider to be close, but your inspiration should be in your work.
Should be, yeah, anyway. I think we need a little of that.
Mm-hmm.
We need somebody to come along to be like, no, you can't do that.
Right.
I know I do.
Mm-hmm. We all need haters.
You know, at least give me one, and then we could definitely, once that fire get up under me, I'll be up all night.
Right.
Is that how you write?
Yeah.
Like, once I write one page, like, I can't.
It's over.
I'll be ready to call off work and everything, and I'll be like, but I still got to get in there. But yeah. Oh, they go, what's the name right here? Montez, he say he'll give you a call.
Okay, Montez, but, I'm looking for you.
Man, I was over his house one day, and he just go in there, and he just doom, 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 doom. And then 5 minutes later, it'd be like a full song, and he'd be walking through the house, like, singing a song. It'd be like 5 minutes later. And I'm like, I don't say nothing to him. Once a person get in their zone, I don't know about music. So I just sit back and be like, you know what? Go ahead. But he's definitely.
That's how it is with me with the song. When I start writing, and my sister, we live together. Mm-hmm. And so every time I start writing something, I go straight to her and be like, and sometimes she'd be like, I don't want to hear it right now. Mm-hmm. Then I make her hear it anyway. Then she'd be all in, you know, like, and she got to write her part.
Yeah, he was doing it with the garbage can and everything.
Exactly. I swear. Yeah. She killed me with that. Then she write her a part in every song, you know. I'm like, okay.
But that's good, though.
She is my inspiration, my sister.
Wait, what's her name again?
Andrea Tiggs. She is my inspiration.
What's the other guy, Darrell?
Daryl Tiggs. That's her husband. Okay. Yeah. Okay. And
definitely get them out there.
Yeah.
And maybe we can get them over here one day, and she can come over and do some singing. She sing?
Yeah, we actually kind of sing a little bit.
I be saying this about singers. Like, I can't tell who can sing better. Mm-hmm. I just know when a person can sing.
I
can't be no judge on like American Idol or nothing like that. Right. I don't know who's better.
Right.
I just be sitting there. But if you can't say, I'll be like, all right, that's terrible.
That ain't it.
Yeah, I know when it's not right. That's what I'm saying. Right. Because people be like, Whitney sing better than, like, she the best singer ever. Some people say that. Yeah. But I like Jennifer Hudson, I think she sound better than Whitney, but people be like, nah. But then I think, you know who Jasmine Sullivan is?
Yeah.
Yeah, see, like, she can sing better than Whitney to me. Like, she sound better. I don't know if it's just my sound. I don't know how that goes.
Right. I mean, that's how I feel too. It's just what their vibe is, you know? Mm-hmm. And so you can't judge a one person say they the best, you know, when everybody got their own little special mix in it, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah. So, let me ask you this before you get out of here about it, since we're talking about music.
Mm-hmm.
Do you listen to, like, gospel music a lot?
Yeah, I listen to a lot of gospel.
What do you think about Dietrich Haddon? That's my man.
I love him.
I just got into him, like, last year. You know what happened? I was watching when he was doing the show,
mm-hmm.
Preachers of Hollywood,
mm-hmm.
and I was like, he a dirtbag. You know what I'm saying? Because he cheated on his wife and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And then after I started paying attention, I'm like, this is a cool dude.
He is.
He can sing, he make good music.
I had the pleasure of meeting his father, mm-hmm. and I was trying with everything in me to meet him so that I wanted him to be a part of this,
I'll be in his inbox every week, once a week, too.
Really?
Yeah. Like, I had listened to this thing, and they were saying about how you could just send people emails. You never know.
Right.
And I'll be doing it. I got it copied and pasted on my phone, so I ain't got to keep typing it. I just go to everybody's name, click send. I just go every once a week.
Need to show me how to do that.
You got to save it to the clipboard. You type it off, save it to the clipboard. Then I just go through the thing. It just once a week. Sometimes I open it up and they look at them, but ain't nobody really responded. But
yeah.
I'm going to keep knocking.
I would have loved for him to play in this movie.
That'd be sweet.
Dietrich Haddon would have been perfect.
You said the preacher, right?
Yeah, the preacher.
Mm-hmm. That's a good joint. So if Dietrich Haddon, if this hit your ears, Miss Arnold got a part for you.
That's right.
Wait, come turn this out one time for.
All right.
Because that's all it take, really, is that one person to come along.
Right. And his dad actually, and mom, I met them both. They have a church over on Schoolcraft.
But he from here?
Yeah.
I definitely didn't know that. I just been listening to music. Then I follow him on Instagram. He be going live and he just be talking. I ain't know that was from here.
And he also has a brother that sings as good as he do. Yeah, I mean, he's awesome.
I like his music because it's kind of him and Ty Tribbett.
Yeah. Oh, I love Ty Tribbett.
They got that kind of like hip hop.
Yeah.
You know, I think that's the most important part today is that middle part.
Right.
Not the church. Not the church people coming over here. No, we need somebody in the middle that can relay the message.
Exactly.
When I had a pastor on here and we was talking about it, but like people from like the hood, we intimidated by suits in church. I mean, like I go to church and I'm getting in there, you know what I'm saying? But like I'm talking about them, I remember them first couple of days, you go in there and you be like, oh, like this is too churchy for me,
right?
And that'll push you out the door. That's the last
it
thing
will.
You need to
I said the biggest people that knock people out of church is church people. And it's a shame to say that, but it's the truth, you know, because they will make you feel like you're not good enough or you're not on that level.
But that's what I say. Do it be that, or do we just have a guilty conscience? That's what
it actually be that.
I mean, sometimes it be, but I'm just saying, like, you know, that be my point to people who thinking about going to church.
Mm-hmm.
It might not be that. It might be you.
Maybe in some cases, because I've heard people say that pastor's talking straight to me. Well, that's your bad.
You like that.
You wear these shoes, you know. You got to put them on and like run in them, you know.
My nephew like he talk about me. I'm like, boy, if you sit down somewhere, he talking to you. But you can go up there and let it out if you whatever you got in that bag. You better go up there and let it out.
Exactly. Give it to him. I'm telling you.
If he wasn't in here, he'd be talking about the same thing because you know. I believe that when somebody got their path and they going and you what you doing,
mm-hmm.
either people gonna follow you, either way go, you still gotta go. That's just like Book of Eli. Remember he like, I'm going west. He like, right. I don't care who coming, this is what I gotta go
this
do.
This is where I'm going.
And that's what I think we gotta do.
That's why I said roll with me or I'm gonna roll over you.
Yeah, that's all it is, man.
Yeah.
Let me put this up one more time before we get out of here, man. We got make sure y'all don't miss it, man. Every Saturday until we fill it up.
Yeah, till we fill it up. Every Saturday at 3:00, we meeting up. We're and then once we get all our characters, that's when we'll give the dates of the rehearsals type of stuff.
But
yeah.
What's the I would say what date would you be wishing for? How soon you really?
I'm hoping that because I did a show on Wayne State's blog show too. So I'm hoping that through this and I've been passing out flyers that we can have all our characters by the end of next month.
Okay, that's what I'm saying. How many people do you have already?
I have about 14 altogether. So 14, not 15. I'm not that far. I am not that far. But I need extras too. You know, these are just my main characters. Mm-hmm. You know, there is not a one star. I loved how this show goes because there isn't a one star in it. Everybody's a star. If you're in this movie, you are a star.
So you say it's like high school, like
yeah, it's like a
episode. It kind of be like, kind of like Saved by the Bell or something. Like how every episode was kind of like about somebody else.
No, I would say it's only one movie, but you know,
it's just like how it goes. It
talks about the girls, the group of girls, then it'll go to the group of boys, then what the boys doing, then what the girls back. You know, it goes like that.
Yeah, so we just need people that's ready to go.
Yeah.
We don't need nobody jumping in and out.
No.
If you're going to be in it, let's get this done.
Let's be a part of F.O.C. Production Company.
And you'll be able to pull that out on somebody. I was in a movie. Was you? No, shut up.
That's what I always say. If we have to make money on this just by selling the movie, who can't sell a movie that you're in?
That you in.
Because everybody you know, you're going to be like, hey, I'm in this.
I'm about to come downstairs. That's
exactly. So, yeah. So, you know, come on out and help us get this production together. It will be a really good idea. It's going to be it's a great movie. Needs to get out here. It's just a altogether good thing. And you will make something off of it. Like I said, if we have to straight up sell CDs of this movie to make some money, we going to make some money off of here. Flat out.
He said he rented the theater. And so you can rent
that's
the theater.
Now, that's one of the things I'm going to do. I'm going to rent out the Bel Air Theater in Southfield when we get done with it. And we will air it there. And then we'll have it for like 3 days.
See, that's sweet. And
yeah.
It's just all about getting people out then. That's what I say.
Yeah.
But if you have 300-400 people in a spot before, that's good to go right there.
That's what's up. And so I got this this couple, they are producers and they're helping me out as far as giving me actors and actresses and singers and all that type of stuff too. And then
you ain't getting no Facebook groups?
I don't. I would like to get on some. I'm not on none yet.
I'm in a little podcast group, and I'll be in there asking my questions, and they be answering them. Like, it be people in there. So I'm just sure they got casting call groups. They got every kind of Facebook group. You know what I'm saying?
I'm going to have to look them up. I'm really not a big Facebook person. I'm, you know.
You're right.
But
that's what I say. Like, some people, that's where the team come in at. She need a team. Somebody should have been like, you know.
Right. But if you go through my Facebook page, it's TRA, you will see a lot of my different writings that's in there. Because sometimes I get bored and I just make a poem and put it on Facebook, you know. And so, and there are lots of them. So you'll see the style of writing that I do. If you just go through my Facebook page.
We coming with the movie. We ain't going to worry about the writing. We going to get this movie done because I could definitely say I had you on the show.
When
I say I'm going to be sitting back watching TV and you're going to be getting the Image Award or something. Up there, I'll be like, yep.
I'm looking forward to that. Yeah. I am.
I said when I do my movie, I'm wearing the, remember Nino Brown had the black with the gold buttons?
Yeah.
That's what I'm wearing up there to get my Oscar. I already got my outfit picked out. And that's what I'm wearing. No socks. I'm going up there just like
that. No socks.
I might even
he didn't
my,
have on no socks
he
either.
He don't have on no socks. He was on the show. He like, hey, y'all gonna see this.
Right.
We got Tracey Arnold in here, man. Y'all make sure y'all definitely get with it. What you got? Just Facebook? That's all you got?
Yeah,
you got
right now I'm just on Facebook. Yeah,
see, I'm going to have to jump in there and give you a rundown. You
I told
Instagram
you I'm
going to
need your help. I'm going to need your help.
You got to get the Twitter going. When I hit send, it go everywhere. Like I'll be trying to get anybody because I got like some shirt designs and stuff. I'll be jumping to people inbox, man. Y'all go listen to me. One of y'all. As soon as y'all crack that door, I'm all up in there. So y'all make sure y'all definitely get in there, man. I'm going to throw this in here one more time, man. Every Saturday, 3 p.m. until she fill it up. She says she need like 17 more people.
Mm-hmm.
But we'll definitely take 40 more people.
We will.
Okay,
because I need extras too.
She needs extras too. So maybe when you get everything together, you can I'll put it on here the day that you need the extras.
Okay.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because, you know, people, you know.
Right. Because I'm trying to do the filming with the extras on weekends only. So hopefully that'll work out good. Yeah.
That's why I say something like that where people can come with their, because it's a church scene?
Yeah. Three of them.
Yeah, so you need a mixed bag in there. Mm-hmm. Okay, all right. So yeah, the weekend will be better. I got I got five kids, two grandkids.
Right, and then I got to fill up classrooms, you know?
No, I'm talking about me. I can't do no classroom. Because you're going to high school, right?
Right.
Yeah, you can't hide. Right. I don't think I look like no teenager, and I ain't about to put no makeup on.
Makeup.
Cut the mustache off. None of that. But I'm there with the church scene. I bring the kids. I got my girls. And I got, that's what, eight people right there.
What's up.
Get my dad, somebody.
Yeah.
You can fill a room up.
Man. Right, exactly.
All you got to do, I say you got to offer food.
Right. I am. I have a caterer that's going to be coming out. And when we start to actually filming, and they're going to be feeding my people. So, yeah.
There we go.
So, that was another thing that God blessed me with. Yeah. You know, because I didn't even think about that part. And it was like, hey, you're going to need some food.
That's how, like, that's how you get people out.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to feed everybody.
Please, man, go you know it. And lay it on out.
Right.
Man, we got Tracey Arnold in here, man. Y'all make sure y'all go. She's on my friend list. She added me today.
Mm-hmm.
And it's T-R-A. It's not your full name. It's just T-R-A on my friend list. I tagged her in the title of this. Y'all just make sure y'all add her and just stay in tune with everything that's going on. If you can't make it to the auditions or casting call, we should say, not auditions, yet casting call, just, if you can, just share it. It don't cost nothing. It don't mean nothing to share it. Everybody got somebody in their family that think they can act. Here go their chance to prove if they can.
Right. Come on now.
You never know. You got, once you get in there, you might end up getting moved around. You might end up being a main character. Who knows? But you got to get up there first, and it's free. That's the main thing.
Right.
Ain't nobody trying to charge off of nothing. So what is that? What day is that? Saturday, man? Y'all not doing nothing on no Saturday afternoon. Get up while you get up. Enough time to eat. Get on over there. How long are you doing? Is y'all doing readings or how's you going about?
Well, like I said, we're just signing people up right now. So you just come in, give your name, saying that you want to be down, you know, pretty much. And then we, you know, once we get all the people, then that's when we'll start the actual auditioning and doing all that. Yeah.
You know, but first things first, get up there.
Get up there.
She got a good vibe. I don't know how y'all feeling it through the screen, but we was here a little bit before we started, and everything cool. And plus, she come via my brother Tony.
Yeah.
Yeah, he top five coolest dudes
in the world.
Yeah, so if he said you this way, it got to be something good. So other than that, man, we gonna shut it down, man. I play Reminiscing by Moe Corleone, man. Y'all know, go shop refreshus15.com, deuce5clothing.com. And DetroitCousin.com, and y'all make sure y'all check out everything that we got going on, and I'm gonna get up out of here.
Thanks for listening to
Mike with the mic.